Porous borders, the lack of rule of law, and the defeats in Iraq and Syria have now prompted many European and Western members of Daesh to go to Afghanistan in order to continue their brutalities and violence. After reports of the deployment of hundreds of French, Algerian, German, Uzbek, and Arab terrorists to Daesh-controlled areas across Afghanistan, the arrival of British terrorists has now created more problems for the Afghan government. Kabul has confirmed the presence of foreign nationals among Daesh terrorists, saying the resolute stance of the government will finally defeat them.
Our commandos, Air Force, Ground Force, the 201 SLAP Corps, National Police and National Directorate of Security Troops have recently launched a joint military operation. Achievements are big. Some areas have been cleared of enemy presence, and dozens of Daesh terrorists have been killed or wounded. Fortunately, we had no casualties.
While Daesh is struggling to bring more areas under its control, particularly in the northern parts of the country, the Afghan government also claims that unlike previous counter-terrorism attempts, this time things will be different. Despite almost daily reports about the army's victories against terrorists with various affiliations, Daesh terrorists have a growing presence in Afghanistan. However, many Afghan politicians blame Kabul for not combating Daesh due to secret reasons.
The Taliban say that when they were engaged in battles against Daesh terrorists, Afghan military forces arrived. This caused the Taliban to retreat in order to avoid joint operations with Afghan army forces against Daesh. But it was a tactic to pave the way for Daesh to gain more ground, because Afghan forces always leave the area to Daesh just after the Taliban retreat.
Many, including some members of the Afghan parliament, have accused some bigger players of supporting this newly emerged terrorist group in Afghanistan. They believe that the reason for Daesh's expansion in Afghanistan is for the group to gain a foothold in other Central Asian countries. Experts believe this is a wrong strategy which has already created concerns not only in Afghanistan but also across the region, particularly in neighboring northern and western countries. Amin Alemi, Press TV, Kabul.